Measuring energy consumption of embedded or IoT device is an essential task for all hardware and software developers striving to develop energy-efficient products. The following instructions demonstrate how to accomplish this task using Otii Arc or Otii Ace with the accompanying Otii Pro software. This guide specifically uses the Otii Ace, but the steps are also applicable to the Otii Arc. Connect your Otii Ace to your computer via USB or connect it to a power outlet using a power supply. A blue light will turn on, indicating that the Otii Ace is ready for use. Connect the minus battery connector of your device under the test to the Otii Ace's minus battery banana connector. Connect the plus battery connector of your device under the test to the Otii Ace's positive battery banana connector. Your Otii Ace is now set up as a both power analyzer and a power supply. It will begin supplying power to the device under test according to the parameters set in the Otii app. Additionally, the Otii Ace will measure current consumption, voltage, power, and energy for the device under test. So let's get started in the Otii app. Start a new project. In the sidebar, you will see all Otii devices connected to the computer. You can measure data from more than one Otii hardware at once, and you need to add the devices you want to use to the project before getting started. In this case, we only have one Ace connected. Let's add to the project. You can rename the device by double-clicking the name. Let's rename mine. By default, the Ace will act as a power box, which means it will provide constant voltage to our device under test. We set the voltage of the device to 4 volt. We can add overcurrent protection. Let's set it to 1 amp. Then we need to choose what channels we want to record from the Ace. Let us select main current. When selecting main current, main power is automatically selected. This is because it's needed to calculate the energy consumption of the device. When we are done, we can hide the configuration by pressing the arrow left of the device name. In the sidebar, you can now see two items in the measurement section. Measurement is a configuration of channels on the Otii hardware that is measuring. The measurement item lets you set the sample rate of the device and some view options that we will look into later in this video. You can rename the measurement if needed. You can also hide a measurement by checking off the color box in front of the name. Let us hide the power channel. A hidden measurement will still be recorded. It is only the visual graph that is hidden. Now it's a good time to save the project. You should save the project to a local drive that is not synced to a cloud. You should not use a network-connected drive. Choose the name of the project and the folder where you want to save the project to. A new folder with the project name will be created, containing the project file and the data directory. Now let's start a recording by pressing the recording button. What we see here is only noise. Let's turn on the power by pressing the power button of the Ace. Now we are recording current and power data from the Ace. By default, you will see the last 5 seconds of the recorded data when recording. By pressing the fit width, you will see all the data. In the toolbar, we have the three mode buttons: selection, zoom graph, and drag graph. With selection selected, you can make selections in the graph. You can adjust the selection by dragging the edges, and you can move it by holding Control and dragging the selection. If we select some data, we can use the zoom to selection button to zoom into the current selection. Clicking anywhere in the graph will remove the selection. The zoom graph mode lets you draw a rectangle that you want to zoom into. The drag mode lets you drag the graph both horizontally and vertically. You can also use the scroll bar above the graph to scroll the graphs horizontally and to change the size of the viewport. Each measurement also has a setting for automatically adjusting the height. You can choose between no fit height, fit height view, and fit height project. By default, the setting is fit height view. This means it will adjust the height to the device visible in the view. If we zoom into the active period, it will use the peak of the period to set the height. If we change it to fit with project, it will use the maximum peak of the project, so it won't change the zoom level when scrolling through data. In the upper right corner of the graph, you can see a statistics view. By default, it shows the statistics for the whole project when nothing is selected. When making a selection in the graph, you will see the statistics for the whole selection. When selection is removed, we are back to the default for the whole project. This can, however, be changed to show the statistics for what is visible in the view right now by getting into Settings and changing Statistics to View. You can create as many recordings in your project as your computer storage allows you. This is especially useful if you are doing changes in the hardware and software and want to do comparisons for benchmark or regression testing. You can hide and unhide recordings during and after recording. Right-click on the recording name. Change the colors or rename the recordings to keep track of what was done. You can offset current recording with pressing Alt plus Drag Graph. In the Statistics view, you can compare the current state for the whole view or a selection. Export all the measured data, meaning export recordings, to CSV file by right-click on the recording in the sidebar and choose Export as CSV. Export the project to a zip archive that later can be imported. This is really handy if you want to collaborate with your colleagues, send questions to your suppliers, or make technical marketing material. You just need to send your exported Otii 3 project file to them.